Microbial mechanisms of pathogenicity, exotoxins. So exotoxins are produced by some bacteria during their normal growth and metabolism. So how do they work? Well, one, they destroy certain parts of the host cell, and two, they inhibit certain metabolic functions. So here's a couple examples. One, we have cholera exotoxins and pertussis exotoxins. There are three types of exotoxins: AB toxins, membrane disrupting toxins, and superantigens. First up, we have AB toxins. Now, AB toxins are polypeptides. Now, the A portion of the toxins are active enzymes, and the B portion is the binding component. An example is diphtheria toxins. And the second one, we have membrane disrupting toxins. Now, the host cell is lysed. And it's by one protein channels are formed, and two, there is a disruption of the phospholipids. Now, an example is Staphylococcus aureus. So, an example. Lastly, we have superantigens. Now, superantigens are bacterial proteins. And they cause intense immune response. Now, what happens is that the T cells arrive at the spot of injury or infection, and release cytokines. Now, at this moment, there will be a lot of cytokines, too much cytokines. And when there is too much of cytokines, that's when the host will see symptoms or experience symptoms. And these symptoms can be fever, nausea, vomiting, shock, and even death. All right, welcome to the study time portion of this video. We are going to remember
what toxins are, and what do they do? So we have exotoxins are produced by bacteria. Now to remember what they do, in exotoxins, we're going to use the I and spell inhibit. Because they inhibit certain metabolic functions. And then we're going to use the D and produce or destroy. Because they destroy certain parts of the host cell. So exotoxins are produced by bacteria and they are produced. Now they are destroyed by certain parts of the cell, and they also inhibit certain metabolic functions.
We have to remember the three types of exotoxins: the AB toxins, the membrane disrupting toxins, and superantigens. Now in the names, they pretty much give us a hint and where we can start in remembering everything about each one. So with the AB toxins, A is active enzymes or active component. So active component of the toxins, and B is the binding component. We have to remember that these toxins are polypeptides. And I think that's about it. The example is a diphtheria toxin. All right. Membrane disrupting toxins. Well, what do they do to the host? Well, they disrupt. So they lyse the host cell. How do they disrupt? One, they form channels. So protein channels. And two, they disrupt the phospholipids in the membrane. Phospholipids. Third, we have superantigens. Antigens are proteins, so they're bacterial proteins. And they cause intense immune response. Super, think of super, intense, link those two up together. So they cause intense immune response. So the T cells will go to the site of infection, release cytokines, a lot of them, too many. And when that happens, the host cell, or the host, will feel symptoms or have symptoms. And what are these symptoms? Fever, nausea, vomiting, shock, and even death.
It's time to test your knowledge on exotoxins. So, question. How do exotoxins affect the host? And then I want you to fill in these blanks. Tell me all about AB toxins, membrane disrupting toxins, and super antigens.